They always do this, don't they? Well, a few oranges. Mama used to have these sunglasses like Roy Orbison. She used to listen to Roy Orbison when I was younger, and I wanted a pair of sunglasses like these, but I had no money to look. Shut your mouth. So I had no money to actually get these sunglasses, so I was like, I don't even know where to start looking. And I walked past here one day and there was a Blues Brothers costume. So I got these sunglasses for like £2 or something. I thought I looked cool with them on, so I kept wearing them. And then when the band brought out the album, record deals and all that stuff, then Ray-Ban sent us like 100 pairs of these big boxes. Just endless amounts of these sunglasses. They thought they were Ray-Ban, that I was like advertising their sunglasses on like, in a magazine or something, but but they were actually a Blues Brothers costume. This is the Clyde here. And this is a bench that was put here with a photograph of Chris Donald. And one of the songs that I wrote, Flowers and Football Taps, was in his honour. This is a beautiful place here. I never knew the guy. I saw a photograph of him and his family in the newspapers, and straight away I fell in love with him. And maybe we'd never met before, but he's still my brother. So this is where I wrote the first album. I would just record in that wee living room there. Like, there was power cards. You need to have power cards to have the electricity on. And I just never had any money. I mean, when it was grim, it was quite grim. Even when you tried to make it more exotic and tropical, it was hard. I'd make it like a white Russian, but I'd make a pint of white Russian. You'd be sitting with the electricity, man, with a pint of white Russian in your hand. You would try and make it exotic, but it was hard. I'd watch The Wonder Years as well. The Wonder Years was always on every day, and there would always be some bit of knowledge, life lesson, some kind of enlightenment in that I would take for it and then start writing. You know, it's like I've got memories like walking along that road just there and writing the song Daddy's Gone and trying to remember all the lyrics and remember the melody and the way I could imagine the song. I was just really scared that if I didn't get home in time, then the idea would float away into a song graveyard in the sky or something. Oh, oh, have you my hero? Oh, oh, have you never healed? Oh, remember times when you put me on your shoulders? How I wish it was forever, you would hold us. Thank you.
what was I doing there? Right, so.
Glasgow's quite an extreme place. Extreme humour, extreme love, friendliness, kindness, and frustration as well, anger, which is violence, extreme confusion. Nothing in the middle, I don't think, that much. It's like where the clouds are above Glasgow, underneath the clouds, there's some magic for me. It's home.
Remote controlled fart machine number 2. Boombox technology. 15 louder sounds. New, works up to 100 feet. As advertised on the Howard Stern show.